Hello and welcome back. I am the Otaku, and today we are going over the Star Wars Battlefront A280C blaster rifle, or what I like to call my bro. To be quite honest with you, I didn't actually call it that until now, but giving each blaster a nickname is somewhat of a tradition for these videos now, and I had to think of something. So why do I call it my bro? Well, that's because the A280C is a very reliable blaster. I thought to myself that it reminded me of someone who's pretty decent at everything, and while there may be other people better suited for a certain situation, when it comes down to it, you know he's somebody you can rely on to do his part, and he's always got your back. So enough of me being silly, let's pull up the stats from Synthic.com, and let's see what Bro can do. As always, there's a link in the description below if you want to check that out yourself. Directing our attention towards the damage chart, you will see that Bro starts off doing 25 base damage. At 10 meters, the damage will start dropping down, and by 60 meters, it will be at 12. What that means is up close, you can expect 4 shots for a kill, and at longer ranges, you will need 9. Medium range encounters require somewhere between those numbers, but I find it's usually around 5 or 6. The 280C has a rate of fire of 400 RPM, or rounds per minute, which is slightly above average in fully automatic blasters, but you can expect enough rounds going out with that that you aren't severely punished for missing. Bro really knows how to give it his all, and able to dish out 27 rounds before overheating. To be honest with you, that is a lot of rounds without stopping. You aren't going to run into this situation very often. The base recoil on the 280C is 0.1 horizontal, going both left and right, and then 0.2 vertical. This is very, very little recoil and pretty much never has to be actively managed. The 280C Bro Edition has no base spread and increases at ridiculously low 0.03. Once again, don't even think about it because it's not going to matter. I realize that no heating, no recoil, and no spread sounds great, and it is. That is the main selling point of this blaster. But do keep in mind that the damage and rounds per minute are not going to win any awards. I took a peek at the time to kill charts as well, and it's pretty average or below in just about all distances. It does perform just marginally better between 15 to 25 meters, so it's best at medium range, but clearly meant to just be a simple, all-purpose weapon similar to the E-11. To put that more simply for you, what I'm trying to say is that the 280C is not going to blow someone up in record speed, so if that is the kind of blaster you want, I would check out some of the other blaster videos I have to find something that you like. With this Bro, essentially, it's just aim and shoot. You have no recoil, no spread, can shoot 27 rounds, and at half-decent speed. The A280C abstracts away from all the situational-type weapons in Battlefront to something just a bit more simple. Overall, this gun is just reliable as hell. It's going to shoot where you aim, it's going to function very, very consistently, and there isn't too much else to it. I played around with some different loadouts to test things out. I found that explosive rounds work, but they weren't particularly amazing. I think explosive rounds just in general do better on high rate of fire or the burst weapons. So I went with scan pulse and used the scout trait most of the time. And if you're watching the video footage, you would have noticed how well that actually worked out for me. There was multiple situations where I was just a little off to the side, and scout was keeping me off the map, and the scan pulse was allowing me to engage enemies on my own terms. I ended up getting 5 to 10 kills in a row in multiple different games. Now, in case you didn't notice, I'm a pretty good player. I have a good KD, win rate, etc., and to be honest, I was kind of expecting to be held back a little bit. But in fact, every game that I played to get footage, I did really well, with scores like 23-3, 33-4, and the last game you'll see, I got a score of 70-11, which is really not bad at all for an infantry player. I think the simple, consistent, and straightforward mechanics of the weapon, together with the insane 27 rounds before overheating, made it really easy for me to engage one enemy after another and take advantage of scout trait and scan pulse. Now, I think using something like the DL-44 EE-3 in the same situation in the footage for this, I would have likely overheated or lost a gunfight earlier due to accuracy, range, or whatever other weakness those situational type weapons have. So what do you think of the A280C? Is it your bro? Is it too much of an average Joe? Or is it just a friend of a friend? Leave a comment in the description below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos. Or don't, if you suck. Whatever. As always, may the Force be with you.